Most people that die of cancer die as a result of metastasis, where the cancer cells disseminate from the primary tumor and cause systemic disease, and tumors come up all over the patient's body. And it's been known for actually decades that distant metastasis by cancer cells is a very inefficient process, in which a tiny percentage of the cells that disseminate from the primary tumor actually survive to grow tumors at distant sites. And that's why it takes typically years for a cancer to progress from a primary tumor to systemic disease. So we studied this process and discovered that one of the key limitations in distant metastasis is that the cancer cells experience oxidative stress. And most of the cancer cells die as a result of that oxidative stress. What this means at a big picture level is that the idea that antioxidants are good for you is so strong, but our data suggests that the cancer cells benefit more from the antioxidants than normal cells do. And in fact, the mechanism by which antioxidants work is by neutralizing these reactive oxygen species. So when we took mice with human melanomas and we gave antioxidants to the mice, it actually enhanced the ability of the melanoma cells to metastasize, and the mice developed a higher metastatic disease burden. So that was the exact opposite of the way people think of antioxidants being good for you. Given, I think, now the mechanistic evidence in our patients, specific reasons why cancer cells may benefit more from antioxidants than normal cells, I think this needs to be rethought. And our data suggests that instead of treating cancer patients with antioxidants, that we should be treating them with prooxidants that exacerbate the oxidative stress experienced by the cancer cells, that'll kill the cancer cells more effectively, or inhibit their ability to undergo the metabolic changes to cope with the oxidative stress they experience during metastasis.